that you know that you're not tracking everything and you have control over what's going on behind the scenes. Yeah, my name is Bernd. I'm 32 years old. I'm a graphic and digital designer based in Stavanger, from Norway, ex-Houston, London, Copenhagen resident. And today I'm working in Figma, I think, for Vivaldi. Bunch of different reasons why I think it's important. Maybe the two most like day-to-day things are like tracking with ads. I really hate it when I search for something, and working with a lot of different clients and different companies, I Google everything and then suddenly I get ads for things that I Googled because of a project, which is just really annoying. So that's one like day-to-day thing that really bothers me, that it tracks all my Google searches and so I use DuckDuckGo, or I try to use private mode. Working for a client who's an architecture company, and we're doing their website. So what I need to do is to make some prototypes, and I also need to find some inspiration for videos and pictures and what kind of style they're gonna have on these different sites. So it's basically like a photo brief for the photographer, and it's also a style guide for the client as well. What we could start by doing is opening a new tab here, and let's see, modern Scandinavian architecture. So now I'm doing this in DuckDuckGo, which is probably one of my preferred search engines. There we go. And then let's do under pictures. So what I know about the client is they like really like minimal stuff, and they do a lot of cabins and cool villas. So what we want to do is try to find some different pictures. So I'll try to grab, let's do this in a new tab. And oh, this is super nice. New tab. So this is probably one of the most common, well, not problems, but common things that happens is I have like 30 tabs with pictures. So if I'm not mistaken, I should be able to group these under, there we go. And then I can actually do, so the new trick that I like is to get like a grid view of the things that I have opened, which is really smart. So then I can see what kind of pictures I've chosen and see if the style sort of makes sense as a whole. Let's do a new tab for this. There we go. So when I open a new tab, it just puts it side by side, which is really nice. So let's just grab these pictures and put them into our Figma file. So we'll just do a new one and call it mood board for photos. All right, super quick. Let's copy picture, paste. So yeah, so this is usually what I do. I would just find a bunch of different pictures, and just mood board so that we have something to discuss with a client. And then I would try to use, let's say, so this picture is pretty fitting for Stavanger, which has a lot of sea and nature and a lot of wooden structures. So if we put that, we could take it into the web design. And let's say we're using this, and then I should be able to paste it directly in there. That works like a charm. So yeah, so that's one way that I usually mood board and work in Figma is basically just stealing stuff from other people. It works really well. People think I'm really talented when I take other people's content. But in general, it's a good way to mood board and to find inspiration and be able to present to the client. So what we would usually do is just share this Figma board directly with the client, and they can go in and comment and use Figma in the browser for that. Another thing I wanted to test out really quick, just to see how this works in Vivaldi, is the prototype function. So I have this idea for an animation that I should be able to prototype real quick. Let's do an artboard and desktop. So basically what I want to do is, when we go from one screen to another, I want these to go together. So let's do this. So this is mostly just to see if it's as easy as I think this is. Let's go back there. And grab this. So that's another really good thing about Figma, and also a decent browser, is that you can prototype pretty nice animations. And if the browser is good enough, it should flow super smooth. So let's do on click. We're navigating and we're gonna do a smart animate. And let's just wrap up. Let's see if this works. I'll just put these together in a tab. So now when I click on this, there we go, it should animate. Now I can even animate it back if I want to, just to see how it works. There we go. This prototype, add, click, navigate to, and just boom. Let's see how that works. There we go. So that was super quick and easy. So that's a bit of Figma in Vivaldi. In general, it seems to be super smooth. It's the same with Webflow, that sometimes these prototypes just have a tendency to sort of clog the browser and everything just sort of lags, but this seems to be moving just like we want it to. So my final thoughts on Vivaldi, I definitely feel like the way that you can choose what search engines you use and what's being tracked and not tracked is a really nice possibility, because it's not always you know what's going on behind the scenes. So being able to sort of press, you know, you can choose what's being tracked and what's being blocked, and you can choose your search engine. So I use DuckDuckGo, sometimes you use different search engines depending. That's a really nice function. When it comes to Figma, I'm really surprised how well it works and smoothly it works. And you can almost say that it works as well as the app, which is what I would usually use. But this being so quick and smooth was surprising in a good way. So those are my final thoughts.